Afternoon class. Your teacher's sick today, so I'll be taking over today's biology lesson. I have a master's degree in biology, so things should run pretty smoothly. Now, I've taken the liberty of creating my own PowerPoint for today's lecture. We'll start today's lecture by talking about some basics, such as the organs inside your body and what their purposes are. Now, this, as we all know, is the human brain. It controls the inner and outer workings of the human body. Now, one question you might be asking yourself is, where does it get the energy to power all this? Does anybody know? Yes, you.
Orange hoodie.
When you eat something with carbs, they break down into glucose, which, doesn't that just power your brain?
Ooh, so close. See, that's actually a very common misconception. You see, our brains are actually more like a battery powered by the sun. Our eyes act as a sort of channel to absorb that solar energy and feed it to our brain. You know, the reason why people tell you not to stare at the sun is because it would overload your brain with all the intense energy and would shut down. Staring at the sun directly for about 2 minutes is the equivalent of powering the entire United States for a month.
Now, right around here is your appendix. Now, many people may tell you that scientists don't actually know the true purpose of the appendix, but that is also a very common misconception. You see, our appendix is sort of a second brain that holds an excess amount of information when your current main brain on top is overworked. The reason why your appendix may burst is because you've simply learned too much, and your brain and secondary brain can't hold any more information.
All right, man, you can stop. It was kind of funny the first time, but some of us actually want to learn.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure what you're referring to, but I would appreciate it if you don't interrupt me during my lecture. Moving on, can anybody tell me what these are? Yes, you, green shirt.
The lungs?
Oh, I'm sorry, it's incorrect. You see, our lung is actually right here. These are our stomachs. See, as man evolved, we began to eat more fattening foods, and we began to eat more often, and so our body realized that we needed to be able to store that excess food, so it grew a second stomach.
This, right around here, is the gallbladder, a rather remarkable organ.
Well, at least you got that organ right this time.
Okay then, Mr. Smarty Pants. What does the gallbladder do?
If I had to guess, I'd say it's a magical organ that helps us to communicate with unicorns.
Gosh, that sure was a good guess, but no. See, your gallbladder actually produces what's called hypergastrointestinal food cells that are responsible for your dietary preferences or any food allergies you might have.
Where exactly did you say you got your master's degree?
University of Phoenix Online.
I think I speak for everyone when I say that I would love to hear more biology facts that you learned online from such a prestigious school.
Well, thank you. Finally, some respect. Right, now, moving on, I'd like to talk about a couple of evolutionary traits that humans have developed over the years. Now, as you're aware, we actually used to be much hairier, but as we evolved, the amount of hair that we grew and the places in which it grew actually decreased. This is because Cro-Magnon people were so fed up with having to shave every single day that they literally willed their body to produce less hair.
Now this, as I'm sure you may recognize, is a dodo bird. As we evolved, we humans actually became much like the dodo bird, and that we became fat, lazy, ugly, and we lost the ability to fly. Now, raise your hand if you've ever gone running and your side cramps up. Would anyone like to take a guess as what the cause of that is?
Nah, man, we're good. You can go ahead and explain it.
Very well. When you run, the insides of your body begin to shake uncontrollably, creating a sort of 9.0 earthquake for the tiny people that live inside of your kidneys.
Yeah.
Is this going to be on the final?
Yes.